The Bible tells us in the book of Daniel 12, verse 4, "But you, Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book until the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall increase." We live in the last days when there is knowledge increase. Now, we read the book of Joel 2, verse 31. "The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the coming of the great and awesome day of the Lord." Now, talking about the day of the Lord, according to the prophet Joel, you read through the whole chapter of Joel 2, he says, "Blow the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming, for it is at hand. A day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness, like the morning clouds spread over the mountains. A people come, great and strong, the like of whom has never been, nor will there ever be any such after them, even for many successive generations. And it shall come to pass afterwards that I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. And also on my manservants and on my maidservants I will pour out my spirit in those days." Verse 30, "And I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood, before the coming of the great and awesome day of the Lord. And it shall come to pass that whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there shall be deliverance, as the Lord has said, among the remnant whom the Lord calls." Luke 21. Verse 25. Jesus is talking about the signs of the times and the end of the age. So let's start from verse 7. Luke 21, starting from verse 7. "So they asked him, saying, Teacher, but when will these things be, and what sign will there be when these things are about to take place? And Jesus said, Take heed that you not be deceived, for many will come in my name, saying, I am he, and the time has drawn near. Therefore, do not go after them. But when you hear of wars and commotions, do not be terrified, for these things must come to pass first, but the end will not come immediately. Then he said, verse 10, then he said to them, Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be great earthquakes in various places, and famines and pestilences. There will be fearful sights and great signs from heaven. But before all these, they will lay their hands on you and persecute you, delivering you up to the synagogues and prisons. You will be brought before kings and rulers for my name's sake." It's happening today. "But it will turn out for you as an occasion of testimony. Therefore, settle it in your hearts not to meditate beforehand on what you will answer, for I will give you a mouth and wisdom which all your adversaries will not be able to contradict or resist. You will be betrayed even by parents and brothers and relatives and friends, and they will put some of you to death. And you will be hated by all for my name's sake. But not a hair of your head shall be lost. By your patience possess your souls. Verse 25, and there will be signs in the sun, in the moon, and in the stars, and on the earth the distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring, men's hearts failing them from fear and the expectation of those things which are coming on the earth. For the powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Now when these things begin to happen, look up and lift up your heads, because your redemption draws near. So, these are the signs of the end times. As Jesus stated in the book of Luke, starting from verse 7 up to the end, because he urges all people to take heed. Verse 34 of Luke 21 says, but take heed to yourselves, lest your hearts be weighed down with carousing, drunkenness, and cares of this life, and that day come on you unexpectedly. There's so much that is happening in the world today. People worried and so anxious about so many things in life. So, these are the days Jesus was talking about. For it will come as a snare on all those who dwell on the face of the whole earth. Watch therefore and pray always that you may be counted worthy to escape all these things that will come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man. So, we see Jesus was talking about the signs of the times and the end of this age. So he has listed a number of things that when people start seeing these things appearing, then they should know that his return is near. That great day of the Lord is near. So Jesus gave the signs that people will be able to see, to experience in the heavens and also on the earth. Starting from verse 29, Matthew 24, verse 29. Immediately after the tribulation of those days, the sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light. The stars will fall from heaven, and the powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then the sign of the Son of Man will appear in heaven, and then all the tribes of the earth will mourn and will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he will send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they will gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. But of that day and hour no one knows, not even the angels of heaven, but my Father only, Jesus said. But as the days of Noah were, so also will the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered the ark, and did not know until the flood came and took them all away, so also will be the coming of the Son of Man be. Watch therefore, for you do not know what hour your Lord is coming. But know this, that if the master of the house had known what hour the thief would come, he would have watched and not allowed his house to be broken into. Therefore you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. Who then is a faithful and wise servant whom his master made rule over his household to give them food in due season? Blessed is that servant whom his master, when he comes, will find so doing. Assuredly, I say to you that he will make him ruler over all his goods. But if that evil servant says in his heart, my master is delaying, he is coming, and begins to beat his fellow servants and to eat and drink with the drunkards, the master of that servant will come on a day when he is not looking for him, and at an hour that he is not aware of, and will cut him in two and appoint him his portion with the hypocrites. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Jesus talking of the wise servants. Chapter 25, starting from verse 1. Then the kingdom of heaven shall be likened to 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. Now 5 of them were wise and 5 were foolish. Those who were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them, but the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. But while the bridegroom was delayed, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight a cry was heard, behold, the bridegroom is coming, go out to meet him. Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said to the wise, give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out. But the wise answered, saying, no, lest there should not be enough for us and you, but go rather to those who sell and buy for yourselves. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding, and the door was shut. Afterwards, the other virgins came also, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered and said, assuredly, I say to you, I do not know you. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour in which the Son of Man is coming. More about the signs of the times, the end times. Matthew 16, starting from verse 1. The Pharisees and Sadducees are seeking a sign from Jesus. Then the Pharisees and Sadducees came and testing him, asked that he would show them a sign from heaven. And Jesus answered and said to them, when is evening, you say it will be fair weather, for the sky is red. And in the morning, it will be foul weather today, for the sky is red and threatening. Hypocrites, you know how to discern the face of the sky, but you cannot discern the signs of the times. A wicked and adulterous generation seeks after a sign, and no sign shall be given to it except the sign of the prophet Jonah. And he left them and departed. Well, we see Jesus tells those people who are seeking a sign from him. He tells them that they'll not get a sign except that one of Jonah, the prophet. These are the Pharisees and Sadducees, the experts of the law. So he warns them. He tells them that when it's evening, people say, it will be fair weather tomorrow, for the sky is red, and in the morning it will be foul weather. Or for the sky is red and threatening, then these are the experts. Just like we have weather experts who predict the weather, what it will be like. These people say that on the 27th of July, the year 2018, there was going to be a lunar eclipse and a blood moon on Friday, July the 27th of 2018. They predicted this one before this date. And when this day came, exactly what they had predicted came to pass. These are experts, men of the world, who predict things. They give warnings about the weather, and exactly what they say comes to pass. Indeed, we are living in the last days. And this, what we saw in the night, the moon being turned into blood, it's simply a natural and physical sign. But God uses the natural things to remind us of certain things. And these things that he wants us to know are the spiritual things which could be taking place, but people are ignorant of. We have seen from the Bible what the Word of God says from the book of Matthew chapters 16, 24, and 25. All these talk about the signs of the end times. Jesus was talking with the Pharisees and Sadducees who were seeking a sign. We see Jesus used to speak in a unique language, in parables, in a heavenly language. And always, whenever he said something, he meant something spiritual, something heavenly. But because people could not understand the language, his language, they always could see things in the natural and interpret them in the wrong way. Unless and until Jesus explained it, they were not able to understand whatever he was talking about. Now the signs that we see, the signs we have witnessed, are physical. Jesus was giving a warning of what would happen in the last days. And he mentioned about the signs that would appear in the sky, in the heavens, and in the earth. The sun being turned into darkness and the moon into blood. Indeed, we are living in the last days, and we have witnessed, just like yesterday, we saw the eclipse of the moon. The moon being turned into blood. This warning was given earlier, and it came to pass yesterday night. Jesus gave a warning 2,000 years ago, and we are seeing these signs appearing in these last days. But most people, even if they see the signs, they tend to ignore them Jesus said that he will come as a thief in the night. He has warned that if the master of the house knew at what time of the night the thief is going to break into the house, he would have stayed up so that his house could not be broken into. He would have stayed awake. So it's simply to say that Jesus was giving a heavenly warning. A heavenly warning in that is the weather warning from heaven. It's meant to remind us of the present generation and the times we are living in. Jesus condemned the generation of that time. He told them that they are seeking after a sign, and there is no sign they are going to receive except the sign of the prophet Jonah. This generation we are living in today is the last generation. The generation that is from the time of Jesus when he issued this warning. This is a generation that is experiencing so many signs of the end times. There are many wonders in the heavens and in the earth. The sun being turned into darkness and the moon into blood. These are physical or natural experiences. As we notice these physical signs in the natural, let us also remember that there are other things in the spiritual also that have signs which Jesus already spoke about. And the things we are seeing them. When the Bible talks about the sun refusing to give its light, it's the same as the sun having been created as a great light to give light or to rule over the day. If the sun refuses to give its light, what do you expect? It will be darkness. And God also created the moon. We read this in Genesis. God also created the moon to rule over the night. So, the moon cannot shine unless and until the sun goes down. And therefore, when the sun refuses to give its light, what do you expect if the moon is around? The moon will take over. And that is what is happening in these last days. The Church of Christ, who God appointed and gave authority to be the light of the world, has refused to play the role of being the light of the world. And when the church refuses to do or to play the role that it was given by their master, then what's going to happen? Some light, some fake light is going to take over. And this is the light of the moon. You need to seek discernment to understand what the sun represents and what the moon represents. The sun gives the true light. The moon doesn't have the light of its own. It only provides the light that has been given to it by the sun. Therefore, as we notice these physical signs in the natural, let's also take note of the spiritual signs of wickedness that are being displayed everywhere these last days. The church of these last days has refused to maintain the role of being the light of the world. It is instead doing things that the church was not intended to do. It's like the sun that has refused to give its light, or the light they are giving is equivalent to darkness. So the Lord is calling upon all people to prepare as the day of his return draws near. And that is why we go to the book of Joel 2, talking about the day of the Lord, the return of the Lord, and what's going to happen in the last days when the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, will be poured, that the young people will prophesy, the young people will see visions, the old people who dream dreams, so that we should remember that the Lord, as he's calling upon the people to prepare for his soon return, people therefore need to wake up, turn away from their wicked ways, repent, and seek deliverance. Whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. The weather from heaven. Jesus gave the warning, and the signs, we are seeing them. Better prepare, because you don't know the hour, you don't know the day, you don't know the hour. But remember, Jesus is coming soon. Shalom.